I am your host, Asha Brister with the Style Center, and I am here with Paris Chanel. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm fine. I know you are mad excited about what's happening today.
Yes, I am. It's been a lot of hard work put behind this.
Okay, so put behind this, meaning your grand opening.
Yes, the grand opening. Yes, it's an exciting time.
Okay, so, like, tell me, has today met your expectations?
It really did. Like, I didn't know what to expect or anything. When you plan this stuff, of course, you have a certain thing that you hope for, but you never know, like, what's going to happen, if the support is going to be there and different things like that. People came out to support, you know, they were there, and I just appreciate everyone for coming out.
Yes, it was a great turnout. Well, it is a great turnout. Great food, great people, great cake. It was, oh my God, that was life. It was. Mm-hmm. So can you tell me, like, what is the name of your agency?
It's Paris Chanel Modeling, Talent, and Marketing Agency Incorporated.
Okay, is there any reason that you decided to pick that name?
Yes, well, I wanted it. I know a lot of people like short and sweet. But mm-hmm. I wanted mine to be what it is. Like, okay. If you want something, I want you to be able to say, oh, she does modeling. She does, you know, talent and different things like that. So if you're coming for a specific purpose, you'll know what you're getting.
Yeah, and you wanted to stand out right. Like yourself. Because you do stand out, girl. And the outfit is lovely.
I tried.
Can you tell me where you got that from?
I got it from Windsor.
Okay. Yes. Oh, yeah. I love their clothes. Yes. Oh, my God. Yes. Mm-hmm. So, okay. How long have you been modeling?
I've been modeling for 12 plus years now. So it's been a long time.
It's been a long journey.
Have you done
runway or commercial?
Everything. I've never limited myself to just one category, which is what most agencies try to do. And my agency is different because if you can fit different molds, then why not go for it?
Exactly. So basically, like you said, a one-stop shop.
Yes, one-stop shop for whatever you need.
Okay, so can you tell me, like, what does your agency has to offer as far as to your talent and to your clients?
Well, to my talent, of course, I'm working for them. I only selected a certain number of models and talent because I wanted to be able to focus on their dreams, aspects, and careers. Most of these agencies, you get lost and you're just a number unless you're a favorite, you know, of theirs. And I didn't want to be that. I wanted to be able to focus on their careers and be able to know each of my talent, like, one by one. I want to be able to see and be like, okay, this person fits this. I want to be able to look at a casting and say, hey, oh, this person fits that. I just want to be real personable and, you know, one-on-one with my talents.
Okay, so as far as your clients?
As far as my clients, I feel like I have the best talent there is. So, you know.
Yes.
So, I mean, whatever they need. Whatever they need.
You got it.
Yes, I'm here to give it to them.
So is your team diverse or do you have a specific team?
Yes, my diversity is key in my agency.
Okay.
Plus size, I have petite, I have runway standard, I have everything you could want. Makeup artists, nail technicians, photographers.
Girl, you is popping.
Girl, I'm trying. I'm trying.
Okay, so tell me, what does a potential talent have to have to join your team?
Most people look at looks. Yeah, that's cool. But you have to have a drive and a motivation. Like, there was a talent. I mean, she was beautiful, but the drive just was not there. You have to really want it and go after it because there are a billion other models and talent that want the exact same thing that you want, but what's going to make you stand out? And I just like to look and see, like, how hungry people are for it.
Okay. And I definitely agree with you. That has been my motto since I've been modeling. Like, you can be attractive and you can have the look of the model, but if you don't have the drive and the potential, then right. You don't have anything, really.
Right. Yeah. You have to be able to deal with rejection as well. I mean, it's a part of the industry. If you can't accept no, it's not for you.
Exactly.
It's a lot of big models that heard no a billion times, and it just takes that one, you know, to say yes, and there it goes.
It does. So, was the process difficult for you, like, picking your talent?
No, because I kind of knew, had in mind, like, you know, what I wanted to go after and who I wanted to look for. So just seeing different things like that, I was like, okay, if a person submitted, I will look at their photos, of course, and then I will see, hey, do you have any experience? If not, that's completely fine. I took on a lot of people who had no experience, but just talking to them and hearing, you know, the drive or their passions and things like that, it just made me want to choose that particular person.
So you also did your research on them,
yes.
Right?
Okay. As a matter of fact, I did.
That's great. Well, it's great that you know what you want, because I mean, sometimes it's hard to know what you want when you're, you know, stepping out real big, doing it big. Mm-hmm. So it's just like, this is a big step for you. Yes. So what inspired you to take this big step?
My mom.
Uh-oh, kudos, Mom.
It was so funny. It was late at night. It was probably around midnight one night, and we were just talking, and out of nowhere, she came back in my room, and she was like, so you're a year, because I gave myself a year after I graduated last year, and I didn't know if I wanted to work for myself or work for corporate, so I was like,
Can I ask, where did you graduate from?
Christian Brothers University.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And she was like, well, your year's almost up. What are you going to do? And I was kind of like, okay.
The
like,
pressure light.
Right. I was like, well, I don't think I'm ready to work for anybody right now. So I feel like God has something different for me. And, you know, we had been in talks about the agency and things like that. And I was just like, okay. And literally 15 minutes later, she came in my room and she was like, here you go. I was like, what is that? And she was like, your company has been formed. So it's just kind of
straight
like
that, like, you have no choice right now.
Like, I mean, but it sometimes it takes that extra push.
It does.
I wanted to do it, but, you know, sometimes we just procrastinate because we're focused on other things. But I'm glad she did push it because it's turned out way better than I imagined.
So your mom is your biggest supporter.
Yes,
she is on your team.
Yes.
So can you tell me how many people are actually on your team as far as the agency?
Well, I still have some people pending, but I do have 70 plus right now.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so with that 70 plus, you're looking into expanding, right?
Yes.
So what would be the number that you stop at for the agency, or
the
you
sky
just
is the limit.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm not even at first. I just wanted a certain amount starting off because I didn't know, you know, how, you know, things were gonna go. Of course, I had high hopes, but I just wanted to see and make sure first. And it's been going great. So now I've done my website where people can, you know, submit and things like that. So.
Okay, so can you tell me, like, what do you expect from yourself, your team, and your modeling agency in the near future?
Nothing but greatness.
That sums up. I love that. I love that.
And I'm not settling for anything less than that. So,
okay.
And I know my talent, like I said, is great, and my team great, so sky's the limit for everything.
Oh, my God. You are so beautiful, like, physically and mentally, like you are. Can you give the people your social media on how to get in contact with you? And also, please give them your new location where you're located. But, people, appointment only. Don't just pop up. So
appointment only. So, my Facebook page is under the name Per Chanel Modeling Talent and Marketing Agency Incorporated. And we also have an Instagram under the same name as well. And our new location is 1331 Union Avenue, Suite 1203. And website, theperchanelagency.com.
Thank you so much, Paris. Congratulations. It was wonderful being here. Everything was a good turnout. And I plan on being here, working with you, sticking tough through it all. And yeah, congratulations.
Thank you.
Videography and photography company. We specialize in capturing all of life's greatest moments. Whenever you need talented and professional service for your special events or business, L3 Media is the company for you. You can contact us at all of our social media sites. You can like us on Facebook, check out our website, follow us on Twitter, or always feel free to email us. We are L3 Media, your number one source for all your videography and photography needs. Give us a call today.
Welcome to the Style Center. I'm Devin Dion, and I have the pleasure with interviewing Miss Kimberly Houston today. How are you?
Hey, Miss Devin, how are you?
I'm wonderful.
Good.
So how did you actually start off with fashion?
Well, I've been into fashion since I was little. I can remember sitting in front of the TV, not even paying attention to the TV, just looking through fashion magazines.
So I need you to hold the mic up.
Oh. Now I got to repeat that. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Start with the intro again.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you don't have to. We can just start off with Kim, actually.
My question was good.
Yeah.
I got to restart my answer.
Yeah.
Okay, can she ask me again?
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
How did you actually begin with fashion?
Well, I have always been into fashion. Ever since I was little, I can just remember sitting in front of the TV, not even watching, and just looking at magazines, fashion magazines. So I've always loved fashion since I was little.
And I see you have a thrift boutique, and I'm not new to your face. I actually saw you in AJ's show, and your items are better than some actual designers that were in the show.
Well, thank you.
Do you actually select each item that's in your boutique?
I do. I handpick everything that comes in the door. I get donations almost every day, and I'll just pick through the stuff and see what's new and trendy, and I'll keep it for the store.
How long have you been open?
It'll be 2 years in April. I'll be celebrating my 2-year anniversary.
In this location or just as a storefront?
I have been at this store, at this location for 2 years.
Have you attended any college for fashion?
Not for fashion. I did attend the University of Tennessee at Martin for education. However, all I can think about is fashion the whole time, so I should have majored in fashion.
Yes. So do you get booked as a stylist? Because you actually did a wonderful job styling me.
Well, thank you. I do get booked as stylist. I do offer personal styling as well as personal shopping.
How do you feel when people compare your store to Goodwill?
First, I don't call my store a thrift store. I call it a thrift boutique. I do feel like I'm a notch higher than just regular old thrift stores. You can't come in and just buy a t-shirt or just a pair of socks. Everything, like I said, is hand-picked, and they're basically boutique items.
So could you tell me a little bit about this outfit I'm wearing?
Sure. Devin came straight in the door, and she fell in love with this cute little, I guess you can call it a high-waisted skirt. It actually goes perfect with this denim top.
And do you remember where you got this item from?
I don't. I get donations. My store is 100% donated. So I get donations and stuff every day from different people. I don't. But I thought it was fabulous, so I picked it out and I kept it.
What made you come up with the idea for a thrift boutique versus a regular boutique?
Because I've always been a bargain shopper. So whenever I go in a store, the first place I go is to the clearance section. Or when I do shop, I shop at the thrift stores. So me being into fashion and love bargaining, let's put them together.
You said everything in the store is 100% donated. Mm-hmm. How do you actually reach out to people? How do people find you? How do people know where to drop off donations?
Well, actually, first going into it, when I first opened, when I tell you my friends and family were a big help, I just said, hey, look, you guys, I'm opening up this store. I need everything that you don't want. I need you to spring clean and bring it to me. So now I pretty much, networking is my friends. When I go to events, networking is my friend. When I go to events, I network and I let people know, hey, you know, when you're cleaning out your closet, bring your stuff to me. And as well as social media. Social media has definitely played a big part in my business.
So, if they drop off everything, is it just strictly, do they continue to have a relationship with you and continue to bring you items, or is it just like a one-time
thing? Most of the time, they do come back. They'll come in and they'll fall in love with the store and with the items, and every time that they clean out their closet, they'll come back as well as to shop.
How often do you place new items on the racks?
Weekly. I get something in like every day, so I'm putting stuff out every day.
Before we close out this segment, I have one more question for you, Ms. Kimberly. How would you describe your thrift boutique in one word?
One word, it would be fabulous.
Fabulous. As we can see from my outfit, it is fabulous. And Honestly, I couldn't tell that this came from a thrift boutique. I would actually think, my friends would actually question me and ask me, did I get it from the mall? And I'll be happy to shout you out.
Yeah, tell them where you got it from.
You have it here with the Style Center. Back to the Style Center. I'm Devin Dion, and I'm still here with the lovely Kimberly Houston. This segment, we're going to display some of her items on the models. Asha will be modeling this vintage dress.
Yes, Asha is wearing this cute little green vintage dress, pleated, and she's accented it with a cute little cute little red clutch and red belt. Don't be afraid to color block, ladies.
Yes, I love the print.
It's really cute.
And now we have our next model, Erica.
And Erica is wearing this cute beige bodycon side high-low dress. It complements her figure well. She also has these cute little gold bedazzled shoes on that just makes the dress look extra hot.
So instead of having a clutch, the shoes are the accent piece.
Yes, honey.
Statement piece, yes. And for the third outfit, we have Erica modeling.
Okay, now Erica is wearing this cute little tribal green and blue color blocking dress. It actually looks great on her. You can pair it with a blazer. You can wear it to church. Put a couple pearls with it. It actually looks really cute on her.
And even if you want to put a belt on to
yes,
it, I would definitely do that.
You can definitely accent it with the belt.
Asha?
And this next dress is for the party. Don't be tardy for the party.
Yes.
Miss Asha is wearing this cute peplum sequin top. Turn around for us, Miss Asha. Yes. This is definitely for girls' night out or a date with the hubby.
I could see myself wearing that at a day party as well.
At a day party?
Yes.
You could definitely do a day party. Miss Asha is wearing this dress. Thanks, Miss Asha.
Thank you. So I noticed that we have female models. Do you also sell men's clothing?
Absolutely. I carry men, women, and children clothing.
All right. What are the size ranges?
Right now, like I said, I get everything donated, so I really don't know what I might get in, but currently I have up to like a 50 in men, 5X, and like up to 4X in women's.
All right. So for the people that's watching, how would they find your store?
Okay, I'm located at 3156 Chelsea Avenue. That's in the North Memphis area. Social media, I'm also all over. You can find me on Facebook, Houston's Thrift Boutique, Instagram, Houston's Thrift Boutique, and Periscope, Houston's Thrift Boutique.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Miss Devin.
Thank y'all for tuning in. You have it here with the Style Center.
My passion for art is my strength. My originality is my destiny.
Artistry is my creative expression.
Being successful in my career is what makes me perfect.
I am dominant and I am loved.
I am strong.
I am unique.
I am wise.
I am driven.
I am courageous.
I am a leader.
I am bold.
I am a believer.
I am ambitious.
I am who I say I am.
I am an artist.
I'm Brittany Bell. Join us for the True Beauty Social 2016 featuring the MUA Beat Battle.
Thank you.
We're going to start with Ms. Andrea. So, name and contestant number, and just tell us a little bit about you and what you do.
I am Angel, the makeup artist. You can reach me at angel@mua.com. Let me see. Contestant number two. Y'all remember that number two? So when they start saying number two, you go, yeah. But I've been doing makeup, I guess, almost a year now. I love it. It's my passion. I'm almost 40 and I found my passion. So you can too.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Angel. Best of luck. And we're going to move on to contestant number.
Hi everyone, I'm Mae. Sorry, my name is Lucidria. How are you all doing today? I'm from Arkansas and I've been doing makeup since 2009 and hopefully you guys love my work today. Nice to see you all.
Furry. I've been doing makeup since I've been licensed since 2004. I first started out doing makeup for the homeless. And then I just started with fashion. I love fashion, I love hair, and makeup is one of my passions. So I put my passion for my purpose.
All right. Makeup
and hunger. All right.
And
three,
contestant
number three.
Yeah, number three. My name is Moselle Maddox. I'm originally from New York and I live in Arkansas now. I've been there 23 years.
Awesome. All right. Well, three, you look like you're from New York. Everything. Okay.
So I'm going to pass out your bags. We're going to get a little music. Can we get a little music in the background? These ladies have 20 minutes to incorporate the items in the bag in their face. Okay? So when I give you the bag, and when I say go, you can open them, okay? So don't touch them yet, okay? All right, y'all ready? Originally, the competition was 10 minutes. But after completing the bags, I said I'll give them 10 extra minutes. Y'all ready? Put your bag down, Cassandra. Cheek. All right, on your mark. Get it. I'm
your money.